As you can see right there, migrants were clashing with Mexican police in riot gear.
There was a peaceful protest. The migrants in the hundreds overpowered the Mexican federal police lines and started running towards the U.S. side.
The press is calling border security's use of tear gas unprecedented and even a war crime. But what if I told you Obama used tear gas at the border almost 100 times? Way more than Trump. I'm Anders Hagstrom, and these are the facts. First of all, peaceful protesters don't, quote, overpower Mexican police lines. This was clearly a riot of hundreds of angry migrants, and border agents were well within their authority to use tear gas. And to those pointing out that some children got tear gassed as well, there's an easy solution to that, pointed out by the Washington Examiner. Don't bring your kids to a border riot. Simply put, this situation is not unprecedented, and neither is the border security's use of non-lethal chemicals as a deterrent. On November 25th, 2013, under President Obama, virtually the same thing happened. More than 100 migrants stormed the US border and security shot at them with pepper spray balls. But rather than cries of it being an unprecedented war crime, no major news outlet even mentioned it. And Obama gave a speech praising his own immigration policies on the very day it happened.
A path that includes passing a background check and learning English and paying taxes and a penalty and getting in line behind it. Everyone trying to come here the right way.
All that happened Sunday was border agents executing the laws of the United States and protecting the border.
People are pouring across our borders, and if you don't have borders, you don't have a country.
And now let's go to some of your comments on last week's video about Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez and Sarah Palin. This guy is so weird. Brandon Clark Arnold says, about Ocasio-Cortez. I think she is so cute, I just want her to be her boyfriend for a week. I'll tell her a MAGA hat means bring socialism. I don't know how he's gonna justify that. And let her walk around outside wearing it proudly. Brandon's got a crush on the socialist Ocasio-Cortez. Oh my gosh, so many commenters want to date Ocasio-Cortez. Kyle Heyman's like, ... I feel like I've dated her. Maybe he's talking about Sarah Palin, who knows. Oh, Eric Jenny, I found a male who disagrees with the two guys who want to date Ocasio-Cortez. Eric Jenny says she, Ocasio-Cortez, is like a dumber, less attractive Sarah Palin. Maybe he has a taste for older women. So much for the whole, like, don't judge women on their bodies. Judge them on what they have to say. Thanks for watching, and be sure to like and share this video if you liked it and want to share it. And don't forget to like our page here at the DCNF Presents the Facts and our friends over at American Voices and The Daily Caller. And if you're watching on Facebook, you can like my page in the description. Thanks for watching.